how lucky do you feel?
We all have a schedule to maintain. If the people supporting us pull out, we all go hungry.
I feel that we've got to the bottom of this case. The man that tried to knife me, his fingerprints were on the knife. And 3 months ago when your business partner was killed, even though that this man wiped the knife of the blood, it matches up to the blood of your business partner. I feel we got to the bottom of this case. I feel that we've got closure.
Sure, my heart bleeds for all those people that have passed on. But in a business, you don't quit when things don't go the way you want them to.
Look, I got a flight to catch. Look, I wish you the very best. I've been cleared of that airport shooting. I'll be taking a flight to North Carolina tomorrow. I realize you like your little sexual fantasies. But while I'm gone, you need to be more precautious. You need to stay away from that window.
Mr. Williams, pleased to meet you, sir. Please have a seat.
Well, yes, I got your letter.
Yes, sir.
What can I help you with?
Well, I am soon to be remarried, okay? My first wife died. There is now suspicion of all things of me having murdered her. All right, it's not the case, it didn't happen. All right, my fiance is aware of this suspicion now. I've called you, sir, to help clear my name. I've read about your work, sir, in the papers, okay, on those other two cases. All right, outstanding job. I said, if anybody can help me, it is you, sir. That's why you're here today.
Are you sure that I can help?
You are the man, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, I'll do what I can.
All right, I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you.
Look, when can we get together?
I'm on your schedule, sir. Please call me. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Williams. Thank you.
You know, Mr. Mattis, what I need to help me solve this case is, you know, your wife. You know, when you married her, could you tell any difference in her personality?
Sweetest thing ever, man. I tell you what, from our dating time to after we got married, of course, business picked up for me. I was away from home a little bit more often, and she was spending more money. so I had to work longer hours and be away a little bit more. But other than that, when I'd come home, she was here for me, and I was here for her. You know, like I said, she started spending more money. I was making more money, had to make more money, and was gone more often. So we didn't see as much of each other as I would have liked to.
What I want to know is, in other words, the relationship up until her death was as good as it was when we first got married.
Yes, it was. Just wasn't as much time together.
Well, business, yeah, right. You know, it's business. And, right. Well, that's all I need to know for now. Thank you very much, Mr. Meadows.
Yes, sir, Inspector. Thank you.
Mr. Mattis.
Yes, sir.
You know, this is my old man. Cabin where I met my wife. You know, you got a nice little place here.
Yes, sir. Yeah, we had it built about 10 years ago.
Well, you know, just like I served in the military for 30 years. Mm-hmm. And then, I met this woman on my dreams. I thought it was a little late for marriage and whatever. And we really had a good relationship, some of the happiest years of my life, and then she got sick with a terminal illness, and then she died.
Sorry to hear that. Yeah.
And, well, I've met this young woman now, because she's a real shy and bashful person. Mm-hmm. Shy and bashful. But she likes to live in the make-believe world. She likes to pretend she's a stripper. Mm. And I've told her to stay away, out on the street, so she's a shy and bashful person, but she likes to get in front of the window. And what I'm saying is, what happened to your wife, I'm afraid might happen to her. I'm just expect to get a phone call any time. You know, it really bothers me.
Yeah.
Woo! Sheriff Winslow, do you think law enforcement is improving?
Well, I think the law enforcement is going to get better around, especially this cold case thing that we're digging up. That should help the law enforcement really good. It's a challenge. It's a challenge to dig up these cold case files and bring them to justice. I know a lot of them go on 10, 15, 20 years and you wind up.
Well, I hope law enforcement has improved. Says you don't know what it's like to have to wait 10, 15 years in order to get your name cleared. I just want my wife's killer caught.
Nothing ever comes of any of them. They just sort of get forgot about. But I think more and more of them's coming up in there. It's a challenge now, and law enforcement is really eager and willing to do something about it. We got better ways of digging. You got better ways of proving stuff.
Well, I'm just hoping that law enforcement has improved since then. And I just want to get to the bottom of this, because you don't know what it's like to be suspected of your wife's murder. And I don't want to have to wait 10, 15 years in order to have my name cleared of this. I've hired a private investigator to look into this case as well. But if your department comes up with any new information, please keep me informed.
Well, what have you got for me today? Mr. Meadows, I'm here for you. Now, I've asked you question after question about your wife, but I've got to have everything in detail, over and over. When I question these people in the places that you've been, Mr. Meadows, I know it's in the report, but can you tell me? I mean, I've got to hear from you. How was your wife dressed the last time that you seen her?
Well, that's easy. We'd gone out to a little small cafe. She was dressed quite elegantly. She had on a nice long black evening gown, her fur coat, her diamond earrings. She had her hair up in a bun, and she was wearing her black high heel shoes.
I know it's been some time, but I need to know, now, are you sure that's the way she was dressed?
Yes, sir, Mr. Williams. That's exactly how she was dressed. Yes.
I'm questioning people, you know, at the cafe, and, you know, you hear loose talk at the bars, and, you know, I'll do, you know, well, what I can. And
all right.
It just takes time. Most time, people just give themselves away. You like when one story don't match up with the other. I mean, a lot of times people just give themselves away.
Uh-huh.
And when somebody tells me one story in 1 week and another one next, you know, they could be suspects. So, you know, things are looking good on your behalf.
I appreciate hearing that, sir. Thank you.
Well, yes. Look,
yes, sir.
I know you're busy, so I know you got to earn a living.
Yes, sir.
As I'll be trying to earn mine.
Okay, thank you, sir. All right, see you next time. Thank you.
I missed you at that church homecoming. You must have another social activity. Well, how are you?
I'm doing all right today.
I see you got that dog on a short chain today.
Yeah. He's been kind of bothering people today. I'd put him on a little bit shorter chain.
You have stuff.
Yeah, I kind of figured that you had a lot of stuff to talk to me about.
I've been over in Thailand training in self-defense. They got some good instructors over there. I need your help.
That's good. That's good. I think the old dog kind of misses him.
Yeah, I think so. So, I don't work. Help me work the streets. Help me get the information I need.
You know, these foreigners come over here and get their citizenship, and they start these gangs, and especially the Chinese, they got some rough ones because they do this karate stuff, and it looks important to these people, and they get into the gangs with them because they like that karate look, and they feel like, you know, if they learn that, they'll be the greatest, so that entices them to join the karate staff. And they come in and start these little groups, and that's not really good.
And I find that has a big impression on the younger people, too.
Oh, yeah, that's what the younger people like at karate staff.
I know we got gangs here, but still, that type of culture, it does have a lot of influence on younger people.
Yeah, they like that karate stuff. That's what draws them in.
And just like I'm saying, I ran into some of it, and I ended up in jail on account.
Inspector Williams, how about yourself?
Okay.
Okay, good deal. How's the case coming?
Well, it's coming along.
All right.
What I'm saying, have you and your wife to be? I heard y'all went out to the restaurant the other day.
Yes, sir, that's correct. Yeah, well, that's right.
What I'm saying, what type of clothes was she wearing?
Does it really matter what type of clothes?
It's very necessary that I have information on your girlfriend. It's very necessary that I have the information on your girlfriend. I mean, what I'm saying is that if these people are out of focus in their description of what they are telling me about her appearance, as well as your wife's, they might not be telling the truth. That's why I want to go over and over this situation. Tell me, Mr. Meadows, what type of clothes was your wife to be wearing when she went out for breakfast that morning?
She was wearing blue jeans, white blue t-shirt.
And what type of shoes was she wearing?
What type of shoes does it matter? What type of shoes does it matter? What Why would that matter what type of shoes she's wearing? Shoes, tennis shoes, I guess. I don't know.
And what type of socks are with the tennis shoes? Can you tell me that, Mr. Meadows?
Type of socks? I couldn't tell you the socks. No.
You know, these Chinese people, they got their own culture. And they come over here and set these neighborhoods up with gang members. And I'm just not going to have that kind of thing. They form these gangs and cause people trouble all the time. And I've got to get rid of that. But they come over here and form these things and they're rough. They're rough guys. They've been doing it for years in their country, and they come over here and set them up over here and get people to join up with the gangs. And they don't have any problem getting them to join in.
Well, my wife did do a lot of walking in that area. You think that street gang may be responsible?
You know, I don't think the Oriental mob was involved in this disappearance, case.
Oh, Mr. Meadows, I've
Greg Williams, come on in.
Well, you're on the backside of the cabin today. Nice view of the lake.
Yes, sir. Sure is. We go fishing right down there. That's the spot right down there. That's it. So, Inspector, what are the chances are of catching my wife's killer?
There's a chance.
Glad there's a chance.
Well, what I'm saying is,
yeah,
if the killer's in town, I just feel that through questioning, he's going to give himself away, but if he's out of town, I don't know. I don't know.
Any major suspects right now?
Well, it's just like there's a number of people who could be a suspect, but it's too many of them with the same stories, you know. It's just going to take more work on my part. Well, I just want to come out and, you know, see if there's anything new on your part.
I'm here. Okay, you know where to find me.
Okay.
All right. Thanks, sir.
Well, what have you got for me today?
You should have been making more progress on this case, Inspector. I pretty much told you everything that I know to tell you. You have read the police reports.
Now, I've asked you question after question about your wife, but I've got to have everything in detail. Over and over. Well, I question these people and the places that you've been.
Inspector Williams, this is the fifth time you've asked me what my wife-to-be was wearing. What has she got to do with this?
Well, Mr. Meadows, when you hired me as an investigator, you know that I deal with reactions. Now, reactions can actually mean the difference where a person's telling the truth or not.
Inspector Williams, it seems like that you may be trying to implicate me also as the suspect here.
Well, I don't really know who the suspect is, but it's just give me grounds to investigate. Possibly be some people at the cafe. I don't know. Everything's got to match up. Descriptions have got to match up.
Yeah. Seems like you're getting right back around to those people in the cafe just to give them something to talk about.
The people in the cafe have been doing a lot of talking. And what they tell me is that your wife had been seeing Jack Lannon on a regular basis.
Mr. Meadows, I'm here for you.
I hired you to clear me!
Well, I just go by the evidence, and I want you to be innocent.
Thank you. I'm glad to hear that, sir. I am innocent.
But, you know, the bad news, it's just not looking all that good for you right now.
Inspector, are you making me out to be the primary suspect here? Kind of sounds like that. I hired you to clear my name.
Well, I'm going to do some more investigating, and we'll see if things come out.
All right. Glad to hear that, sir.
And I hope things work out on your side.
On my side? You make it sound like I'm guilty. Like I'm the primary suspect here.
I know that Jake Lannon is still alive. I was set up by one of his karate students. I got a call from this person telling me that he had information on this case, and when I showed up, well, he tried to knock me off, but it did not work.
He might gradually just you and him run in together somewhere. When you do, maybe you and him can kind of talk about where he's been, and maybe you and him, he can show you where he's went to, so we'll know next time when he takes off.
Thank you.
Mr. Meadows, Mr. Meadows.
Inspector Williams.
I heard you on Sunday today. What about?
Yeah, you've had more than enough time on this case, and I want my wife's killer caught, and so far you haven't come up with nothing.
Now, are you sure? I mean, are you sure you want your wife's killer caught, or did you just bring me in to fail?
If that's true, Inspector Williams, you wouldn't be able to prove anything. So far, you haven't been able to prove nothing.
Inspector Williams, you seem to be making me out to be the primary suspect here.
Well, I'm just following the leads. That's what I'm doing. Mm-hmm.
I hired you to clear my name.
You know, I'm getting to believe that you hired me to fail. I think you're just wanting to look good in front of your wife-to-be. You want to clear yourself in front of her. I just feel that when you hired me, mm-hmm. you didn't really expect me to solve this case.
Inspector Williams, I hired you to clear my name. I'm not guilty.
Well, that's what they all say. I don't want you to be guilty.
Well, glad to hear that, Inspector Williams.
But I want to get to the truth.
Yes, sir. I want you to get to the truth, too.
Well, just like I'm saying, I want to get to...
Inspector Williams, you seem to be making me out to be the primary suspect here. Inspector, you're making me out to be the primary suspect.
Well, Mr. Meadows, you are the prime suspect. Good day.
How do you feel about the update on the DNA?
The DNA brought everything up to date as far as proving a person's guilt. So it's a lot better now with the DNA. If it hadn't been for the DNA, everything was sort of standing still. But the DNA has really bettered everything and got a lot of people out of prisons that wasn't guilty of what they had done, and they served 15, 20 years and get out. It's pretty great.
I brought this investigator, Inspector Williams, into this case, and he doesn't seem to be getting anywhere with this case. In fact, it looks like he's trying to make me out to be the primary suspect.
Oh, there's a lot of people been sent to prison that wasn't guilty. I think a lot of corruption in law enforcement through the years that they had the pressure from the departments ahead of them and higher up than them, and they had pressure on to find somebody guilty. And I think that's the reason a lot of the people that were sent to prison that wasn't guilty. That's the reason they got there, is because of pressure on the department to pin it on somebody. So now that the DNA is coming to play, that pressure's not there anymore. They don't feel like they gotta get somebody that quick, because if they put somebody in there that's not guilty and they find it out later, they got all this money to pay out for these people that spent time in jail and wasn't guilty. They have to pay them off, and that goes into a lot of enforcement budgets. So it's a big...
Well, that's real encouraging to hear, because it seems like all the evidence is starting to point toward me.
Look, how have you been getting along today?
Oh, good. Fine, Inspector Williams. How about yourself?
Okay.
Okay, good deal. How's the case coming?
Well, it's coming along.
All right.
I mean, what I'm saying, have you and your wife, Tobago, I heard y'all went out to the restaurant the other day.
Yes, sir. That's correct. Yeah. Well, that's right.
What I'm saying, what type of clothes was she wearing?
Does it really matter what type of clothes she was wearing?
Well, you know what puzzles me is that, so you remember everything in detail about your wife, the way your wife was dressed, and your fiance, your wife-to-be, you can't remember that much. You know, it skits it. I mean, you know, sometimes you remember certain parts of her clothing, and I don't know, I'm just really confused about this.
I don't see what the problem there is. I mean, you seem to be making me out to be the primary suspect here, Inspector.
Well, maybe it was just that day. You know, just that day, you know, the last time, a certain type of clothes she was wearing. Yeah, maybe that's what it was.
Okay.
The boaters found the body of the river. I've been looking for Jack Land, and my knowledge is still alive, but I haven't been able to find it. Now, these remains turn out to be his body. It's going to complicate things because I have information that Jack was going with his mother's wife. If it turns out to be his remains, this case is going to be complicated.
He's an escaped mental patient from the state of New York. He's been tried and convicted for two murders. And who knows, he may have been involved in a dozen of them.
Doctor, what you're telling me is that the bone structure in the teeth matches the identity of Lamar Craven, not Jake Lennon. Thank you very much, Doctor.
What can you tell me about these cold case files? What can you tell me about law enforcement? Good or bad? Sheriff Winslow, I got the autopsy report on Lamar Craven. And according to the report, he put up quite a struggle. He was an extremely physical and violent person, yet he ran into somebody tougher. Now, between myself, Officer Danbow, and Jim Benson, we've been working the streets and we found out quite a bit. Did you know that this Jay Clannon, he goes by a number of names. His first name being Jackson. Jackson, Jake, and Jack. His second name being William. William, Bill, and Will. And that's quite a camouflage within itself. I mean, he don't change his social security, but what I'm saying, that's why it's been hard to track. I didn't know whether you knew that or not. I'm Investigator Williams, and I'm trying to clear Mr. Charles Meadows. I've tried to talk with everybody in the community that knows him, and right now this case is just, well, it's just not looking all that good. And what it is, I'm counting on you. What can you tell me?
I don't think the man's all that dangerous. He ain't got the heart to kill a chicken.
Those cigarettes gonna kill you if you don't give them up.
Well, I told you I like them, and if they kill me, they just kill me. Now, I ain't gonna blame the cigarette companies. Well, everybody's trying to get money out of cigarette companies nowadays. Go ahead and light him up.
What can you tell me about penicillin chloride? I didn't have an autopsy done on her body. I didn't want it cut up and dissected.
That was a bad thing. A lot of people was given that. And a lot of people was innocent that was given that. So the DNA has really hipped out all this bad stuff that went on.
I'm thinking about having my wife's body dug up. She may have been given arsenic.
It won't show up if it's given small doses for a long period of time. It won't show up. A lot of law enforcement has assumed bodies and dug them up, and they still couldn't find anything. So
this Inspector Williams seems to think that my wife was poisoned, but if arsenic doesn't show up, what's the point in digging her body up?
Yes. Well, I've checked around, and I just can't understand why that, your wife was wearing dress clothes, a dress and everything.
Right.
Yet the reports verify that she was wearing tennis shoes. I can't understand. She was a woman of culture from the information that I got.
Right. What difference does it make what type of shoe she was wearing?
Well, I don't know. There's got to be some explanation. I have got reports that she liked walking a lot.
Right. Okay. All right. It was a late evening. We came in the house. I started getting myself ready for bed. All right. She was on a very strict diet.
She had a very strict exercise routine as well. She had to walk so many miles per day within a 24-hour period. The reason for her wearing tennis shoes was possibly she came home, she just threw on her tennis shoes and then went out for her daily walk or evening walk.
Okay. What enough on that? That makes sense.
Bye, dear.
Look, I've got me working the streets and I'll get back with you, hopefully, right, with good news.
Please go out, sir, and bring me back some more good news. Thanks, sir.
Thanks.
All right. Yeah. Okay.
And yes, Mr. Meadows, and what is it today?
Inspector Williams, you've had more than enough time to help clear my name in this case. You seem to be making me out to be the primary suspect here. I hired you to clear my name.
It seems that all the evidence is pointing towards you.
You're fired!
Well, you get your last check in the form of a money order. I'll be sure to mail it to you.
Wait a minute. Mr. Williams, Inspector Williams, one moment. Come on back. I'm going to write that check for you. And I'm going to give you a little extra. And in case you don't know, I do have friends down there at the sheriff's office. They are on my side on this story. Come on back. Help clear my name.
I can usually tell where a man's telling the truth or not.
Inspector Williams, you've had more than enough time on this case to clear my name. I love my wife.
Yeah.
I did. Okay, you seem to be making me have to be the primary suspect here.
It just seems that all the evidence is pointing toward you.
Are you accusing me of murder? I love my wife.
What I'm saying might be a day, a week, possibly a month. If he's not telling the truth, his story will vary. Mr. Meadows, I've been questioning people in the cafe, and your side of the story checks out.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, Inspector Williams.
But, Mr. Meadows, it's just one thing. I can't understand this. When your wife was found, she was wearing dress clothes, yet tennis shoes. I can't understand that.
Why was she wearing tennis shoes? And dressed up real nice? She wasn't wearing high heels? Oh, okay, hold on. I got it. She had a very strict diet and a strict exercise routine. She had to walk so many miles a day within a 24-hour period. Obviously, when we got back home that evening, she didn't have time to change. She put on her tennis shoes, and went for her 5-mile walk. That's what I'm guessing. That's probably why she was wearing tennis shoes.
Thank you, Mr. Meadows. What did I think of that? A lot of times I can look into a man's eyes. Some don't seem right. I can tell. Sometimes I could be wrong, but I can usually tell when a man's telling me the truth.
T-Bone will be shorter changed.
You must be up some.
Yeah, I kind of figured that you had a lot of stuff to talk to me about.
Well, have you found out about Will?
We've kind of found out that he's out of state. That he's over towards Tennessee somewhere, that he's been gambling, had a big old gambling debt, you know?
Yeah.
That he was trying to get that off his back. But he ain't come home yet. But he said he was kind of going to come home, but it's going to take him a while.
Well, you know, one thing about it, we know he's still alive.
Yeah, at least we know he's still alive.
I thought maybe somebody might have killed him for sure. But,
yeah.
You know, he was a physical person. If they'd done it physically, it'd been hard to get by with by the law. Jim, I want to personally thank you for this fine piece of detective work. Now, if you can give me an address anywhere close, I'll be on my way to Tennessee.
Yeah.
Well, look, I'll be checking with you.
Charles Meadows. I want you to go back with him and tell what happened. Okay, Jack, we'll do it your way. We'll settle it in the ring.
I think you're trying to make her out to be a suspect.
Mr. Meadows, your wife was the prime suspect. And you tried to cover it up. You knew that she was a patient at the Biloxi Mental Hospital. Maybe not when you married, but you knew it since. And you tried to cover it up to save the publication of your book. You're a writer of murder mystery, and you're afraid that it would hurt you with your publisher. What it is, when they found Lamar Craven's body in the river, the boaters found it, and it was analyzed and it was cut up by a knife. Then Jack Barlow's body showed up, cut up by a knife the same way. I done some investigating on your wife, and all three of them were patients in the Biloxi Mental Hospital at the same time. They got out. So I feel it had to be some link. Okay, let's talk at cafe. I found that Jack Lannon had been going with your wife. Jack Lannon is responsible for the death of your wife. See, what it is, they were going together and they had a conflict and she tried that knife trick on him and he took the knife away from her and choked in the process. It didn't work on Jack because Jack taught self-defense. And right now, Jack's in custody right now and he has came up with the knife. I still don't find that to clear it. And the knife has been analyzed and found the blood stains of Lamar Craven and John Barlow on it. So that clears you, Mr. Meadows, but what it is, you want to get your book published to the point that you're just playing with a death penalty. I mean, what I'm saying is law enforcement was getting ready to put the cuffs on it. Because even though you could remember the detail of your wife, the way she was dressed, you couldn't remember descriptions of other people all that good. But what it is, when it was brought up, that was your wife's favorite dress, and well, that took a lot of, it helped you. And when she went to meet Jack Lannon, she switched from the high heels to the women's sneakers. They got some nice women's sneakers that go with the dress.
Come on, have a seat here, Inspector Williams.
Yes, sir.
Now, right over there, right there's a secret fishing hole right over there now. Come back here on Friday, we'll catch some.
Well, yes. Let's go fishing.